I'm just gonna see if I can get this documented. If you notice it goes black or something like that, let me
know. I'll let you know. What is it using?
Quick.
Okay.
Should be good.
If it needs to be woken up or whatever, I'll just.
Did you go in the kitchen?
Yeah.
Would it be smart if I just did this?
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
So I'm gonna say something, I'm gonna introduce us.
Okay. And introduce you. But I'm gonna introduce you, I'm gonna introduce my friend Laura Ortman to the march, to the performing political education fighting formations residency. And this is really helpful because I need to talk about the work. And part of what I do to make it easier for me writing about the work is just to transcribe the things that I say with all the stuttering and all the mistakes. So inviting Laura into this archive, this becoming archive, which is part of what I call the archival multiverse. It's in archiverse. And because there's so many different things in archives, there's image, sound, language, text, all kind of things. So in this archiverse, referencing. So we're indexing work that we've already started. Laura Ortman is a violinist. She lives in New York. She travels all over the world performing. And we have been generous of her time to lend to the formation of a trio project called In Defense of Memory. And it is a formation. It's a fighting formation. We're not like a militant fighting, but we are. And we're not like a, well, we're a trio of musicians. And the idea of the band project is to emplace our music in key places of culture. And so since she's in town, we're going to perform improvisations and develop our language for our discourse. And I wanted this to be a part of this archive because of having a relationship with solidarity of people that were us, solidarity with our histories, solidarity with people with the movements of history and how those movements are projected into the future and into our present. And I wanted to point to the commemoration work of the local archivists and activists who are at this time helping us to remember the events around Los Siete in 1968. There was a group of Chicanos from this area who were accused and arrested of murdering the police officers. You know. And part of this project began with thinking about like how to access that archive, which is that memory, that public memory, that echo of what they had to go through the court systems here, and then their families being involved in this, and broader like racialized issues that are in the reality that's echoed to us today. And I thought that we would perform our improvisations, we would perform this memory, this new language of addressing memory through using sound. And like try to think about how can sound be an effective tool for any kind of like physical social change, you know, or any kind of like physical, like visceral, or like policy changes, or like narrative changes. How can sound be a part of that conversation? So what I decided to do was to focus my political work from what I do as an artist. So as a drummer, I have multiple drums. Usually I play a drum set. And what I noticed is that I play. I play a lot. And the importance of playing is like activating sound in different places in the structure of the drum set. And it's not unlike how I operate haphazardly or whatever it is in the, as an organizer, as an arts administrator, or as an academic, or just how I try to organize people. And I'm interested in I don't conduct people or score out any information. I just try to bring people in the room that I respect, and I respect what they do, and then we will create a new thing. So we're activating each other's, each other. Yeah? Okay.